Today we are back again with the topic that is development of female genital organs. So today we will see how these female genital organs form. For that we need to know there are two sides of genital organ in female. These are internal genital organs and external genital organs. So we'll see one by one how they get developed during the embryology and by what way it used to get fully developed. So let's see one by one. The very first is external genital organ. The main thing which we need to remember that external genital organs include the parts are mons pubis. Then we have clitoris, then we have labia majora, then we have labia minora, and we have your vestibuli, and the last one is the full perineum, or oh, that is cloaca, C-L-O-A. C-A. So this we need to remember is a cloaca, and let's see what is the cloaca. So what is cloaca? So this cloaca is an endodermal cloaca, is divided and form the external genital organ, which we are going to see how it is going to form. Let's see. So what happened during the development phase in the embryology, the cloaca seems like this. There is a structure which seems like this. So these are the swellings and this is the part. So this is the thing, and this is the important thing which we need to remember is called as a urogenital slit. So this is urogenital slit. This slit. So this is the, let's see here, when the embryology occurs, when the baby or the fetus, when it reaches to the 10th week, what will happen? It will start differentiating into a sex. Now what happened when this slit is further divided? Suppose this is our cloaca. This is a cloaca, and in between, if we see, so this is urogenital sinus. This is the bladder area and this is a rectum area. Okay, so now what happened? This slit further, as soon as the body is ruptured, so what happened? This genital membrane is ruptured and formed like this. This small slit is opened and formed like this. And this genital fold will never unite in the females. So what happened here? They formed into two parts like this. So this part, when it is ruptured and it becomes open like this, so this area is called as a labia minora. Okay, so this is labia minora. This perineal cleft, this whole cleft which is inside, is called as a vestibuli. Now what happened? We were talking about the swelling. So this was the swelling which is occurring. So this swelling, which is called as a labioscrotal swelling, is further called as a labia majora. So this will become a labia majora. So this is part is which is called as a labia. Now let's see how the internal organs form. The before knowing the internal organs, one thing which we need to remember, what happened at the 5th week? At the 5th week, to the product of conception, what will happen? Once it is identified, the chromosomes are formed. Okay, so by 6th to 7th week, we see the chromosomes. If it is giving a chromosome XY, the sex chromosome, so it means the baby is going to be a male baby. Okay, and if it is an XX chromosome, it means it is going to be a female baby. This is clear? Now, what happened? If it is a male baby, suppose XY and the baby is male, and we know it will act on the testes. So this testis will release two things. This testis will release two things, which is called as a Leydig cells. Form the Leydig cells, and the another is Sertoli cells. What happens? These Sertoli cells will release AMH, which is known as an anti-Müllerian hormone. And the Leydig cell will release testosterone. This further testosterone will form one thing. It will help, one thing it will do, it will help in development of Wolfarin duct, which we need to remember, that is a Wolfarin duct. Wolfarin duct. So what will happen? This testosterone is one thing is helping in development of Wolfarin duct. Second thing what it will do? It will develop the male genital organ. But the Sertoli cell, which is an anti-Müllerian, release the anti-Müllerian hormone, which will not allow the Müllerian duct, which is forming the female genital organ, and it will say Müllerian duct to be formed. So what will happen? In male, Leydig cells will be there and the Sertoli cells will be there. The Leydig cell will release the testosterone, which will be causing the development of the Wolfarin duct. And the Sertoli cell, what will do? It will do the opposite action to the Müllerian duct. What it will do? It will be suppressing the Müllerian duct formation. So this happens in the male baby. Now let's see what will happen in the female babies. Now what happened in the female babies? We have female babies. Two things will be there. One is there will be no testosterone. This is clear. There will be no testosterone. And there is no or absence of AMH, that is anti-Müllerian hormone. So what will happen here? One is testosterone is not there. So it means there will be no development of the Müllerian duct can be formed, fully developed. So what we need to do, and the conclusion, that male baby structure will be formed by the Wolfarin duct. Male, and the female baby and the Müllerian duct will form the female internal organs. Now let's see how the Müllerian duct formed it. So what happened this Müllerian duct? The Müllerian duct arises from one thing which we need to be very clear for, that. Now let's see how the Müllerian duct is making the internal organs in the female. So what happened during the development stage? During the development stage, there is a one duct. Okay, so this is the duct which is called as a mesonephric duct. This mesonephric duct will decide that there will be a either Wolfarin duct or there will be a Müllerian duct. So Wolfarin duct, if it is a male baby, there will be Wolfarin duct. If it is a female baby, there will be a Müllerian duct. So what happened here? The mesonephric duct, it will arise the Müllerian duct, and the Müllerian duct will be looking like this. So this will be in pair like this. The Müllerian duct will be forming the mesonephric form in the females. It will form the Müllerian duct. Now with the development of the fetal stages, what will happen till 20 weeks? Slowly, these two will start merging. So what will happen? Like this, it will be there. There will be horns will be forming, and the uterus looks like this. Further, what will happen? The uterus will divide this full part into two, and there will be a small septum in between. Okay, with a further development till 20 weeks, what will happen? This will be forming their own fundus. Okay, see here, there will be a fundus like this. Okay, and that septum which was present before, it will get diminished or it will get absorbed inside. Further, there will be formation of the vagina. So what will happen? The Mullerian duct itself will form from the Mullerian duct, the internal organs form. So this will be further making up. This is ovary, this is the fallopian tube. Likewise, we have ovary, and these are the fallopian tubes, and these are the fimbriae. So what will be formed? This will be the vagina, this will be the cervix, and this will be the uterus, and these are the fallopian tubes. These are the fallopian tubes, and this is ovary. And this is how the whole internal organs of the female genital formed. So I think it is very clear.